In this episode, we'll continue to look at Azure SQL database capacity planning, specifically taking a look at some various scenarios and giving our advice and best practices on what to use when. Join us on this episode of Data Exposed. Hi, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed, where we're continuing our discussion on Azure SQL Database capacity planning. I have with me Silvano, who is a program manager on the Azure SQL team. Thanks for joining us again, Silvano.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Anna. Thanks for having me.
And in this video, we're going to dive into some of the scenarios related to capacity planning. And there are a few various scenarios that we're going to walk through. One is, you know, maybe your application is under development and doesn't exist yet, and you want to know where to start. Another is, you know, you already have a solution and you're trying to figure out how you size it when you move to Azure SQL Database. And maybe you're experiencing a significant increase or changes in your solutions, and you're trying to determine how you should shift based on that. So I think that's what Silvano is going to dive in today. And, you know, I'll pass it over to you. What are you going to tell us about first?
Yeah, let's start by looking at a brand new application that we are developing right now. We don't know yet how many users, but we can start guessing about, the amount of data that we will host and the kind of concurrent workload that we need to run. So that this will be the first one. Okay, so let's start from a Greenfield development scenario, right? So we don't have the application yet. We are starting to design it and to start defining what the data model for our solution is going to be. So there are already some estimations that we can start doing about what would be our ultimate kind of storage size that we will need by starting from defining, what the table sizes that we are planning for are, how many rows we are expected to store based on our workload, what kind of indexes we are going to create for supporting our queries, and so on. Those type of informations are our data volumes will give you already a good estimation of what will be the amount of data that will be needed. And then mapping to our capacity planning process, we can start picking up those deployment models and those compute sizes that will give us enough storage space for hosting our workload. And if we really are planning a very large type of data volume to host, we need to remember that we always have the hyperscale compute tier available, which will give us essentially all the kind of headroom we need in order to host this data. Another super important one is what is our needs in terms of transaction log throughput, right? So by estimating what our key transaction sizes are going to be, so how many records we are going to insert as part of a single transaction, and what is the shape of these records, we can come out with a good estimation in terms of log throughput. And again, based on the different compute sizes, we know we have seen in previous episodes that each of them will come with a given limit in terms of log and the ability to ingest brand new data into the system, right? There are some other application workload characteristics like what is the amount of concurrent requests that we are estimating, we are expecting for our workload. And again, this will map directly into the worker thread limits that we have for each compute tier. So by looking at all these different characteristics, you can start thinking in terms of, this is the compute size that we start from. And then keep in mind that in Azure SQL Database, it's not like in your traditional on-prem system where when you have acquired your hardware, that is going to be static and inflexible, right? We in Azure SQL Database, you always have the chance to move up or down in terms of scaling every time you need without basically no downtime. And this is going to be a super flexible option for you. In terms of best practice, we always recommend, some are good old best practices. Make sure that your data model is not kind of throwing away too much space. So make sure that your data types are the right ones. Make sure that how the application is interacting with the service is going to be the most efficient. Like, do not do select start type of queries and make sure that you are only extracting the data that you need. Leverage batching as much as you can so that you can maximize the amount of log throughput that your Azure SQL database instance is offering, and make sure that you can test and monitor your workload as soon as possible.
Awesome. Thanks. These are some great best practices and things that we should kind of think about considering. Now, this is for a new type of application. What if we have an existing application or we're migrating?
Yeah, exactly. So when we already know a little bit about our workload and we have an existing system in place, we can start by kind of trying to match the existing requirements. Like, if you have a system on premises that has like 8 cores or 16 cores, we can start from there by sizing our compute options in Azure SQL database. And also think about what is the expected type of latency that we need based on the requirements. Remember, our general purpose or business critical tiers have different storage types behind the scenes. So we need to figure out which one we need in order to have, you know, closest performance to our existing systems. We have a tool called Data Migration Assistant that you can download from the Microsoft website that can start helping you to basically recommend what is the size, the compute size level that you need based on recording some of the performance counters in your system. Those performance counters are also listed here in this slide. Those are the key information that you need in order to estimate your IOPS, so your IO operation per second, like discrete per second and describe per second. I was mentioning the log throughput, and this is the log bytes flushed per second counter in your Perfmon system on-prem. And then, you know, starting from collecting this information, you will be able to understand what you will need in Azure SQL database in terms of planning. I do have here a quick demo to show you from an existing on-prem system. I'm using a very well-known tool to simulate a transactional workload. This is called HammerDB. It's coming from the tpc.org website, so you can go there and download. And now I'm simulating these 10 virtual users hitting my on-premises SQL Server instance. So I can start by kind of running this workload. And as I was mentioning in my slide, we can start using some of the well-known tools like a performance monitor to take a look at those counters, right? Like in terms of, you know, what is the amount of transaction per second, the amount of log bytes that we are flushing to the log. And I also have here as part of my demo a simple storage procedure that I created and I will share in terms of what is the logic, which is extracting from our DMVs in SQL Server some of these metrics that are specific for our databases here. And we will see in a few seconds that what we can get here is, for example, what is the amount of megabytes per second that we are writing into data and log files, and more importantly, what is the write latency that we are getting out of our on-premises system. You can see here, I have a very fast SSD drive here, which is basically executing those IOPS in a fraction of a millisecond, right? So let's see what we can get instead in our cloud-based deployment. So right now, I do have this instance here where I'm running a very similar workload. Actually, I'm using the same exact tool, but this time I installed this in a Linux VM in Azure to make sure that our compute tier is as close as possible to our database tier. And I'm running the exact same workload against my database. So the same 10 virtual users here and executing a number of concurrent transactions. And if I go back to my management studio here, I can start by looking at the same metrics that I was looking in my on-prem database, right? So this stored procedure will tell me essentially how my system is behaving in Azure SQL database. And we can see that we are not that far in terms of kind of megabyte per second. Remember, we have a S3, so 100 DTU deployment, so very small one in this case. And so we already have good performance here, but in this case, our write latency is much higher, right? So this is telling me that instead of using a standard or a general purpose deployment, I need to start thinking about a business critical one in order to get the same level of latency. At the same time, if I'm also querying my DMDB resource stat DMV that we have available in Azure SQL database, I can start looking at the other dimensions like the CPU, data and log IOs. And I can start seeing here that we are maxing out the amount of CPU and especially the log write percent in terms of log throughput. So this is a clear indication that we need to start scaling up in our system and probably, you know, moving into a premium or a business critical instance is a way to get similar results to what we have here in our on-prem system.
Awesome. Thanks, Silvano. That's a really interesting example of how we can see, you know, how things change and how we can monitor them. And it seems like, you know, this is relevant if you're migrating, but also, you know, if you just have an existing Azure SQL database and you start to monitor those DMVs and see you're hitting some of these limits, that maybe it's time to size up or consider a different service tier.
Yeah, and I will make sure all the scripts and all the different documentation references will be posted under our video here so you can start using them. Okay, so let's look at a slightly different scenario here, right? So we already have our system in place in Azure SQL database and we are projecting or we are expecting something like a new steep kind of growth in the system, a lot more concurrent users. Maybe we are acquiring a new company, so we need to run more users in our systems, or we are planning for some modifications around the application or the schema, the queries that we are executing. Azure SQL database in this case is helping us. We have a feature called Intelligent Insights as part of the performance recommendations in Azure SQL DB that is helping us to understand or detect that our workload has increased and to start taking some actions, right, to make sure that our cloud-based deployment is effectively serving what customer needs. So the Intelligent Insights capabilities are basically recommending us to scale, for example, our system, so just add more capacity, and it's pointing out to the right level of capacity that is needed, but it's also starting to tell us, hey, if you are looking if you're looking more closely into resource consumption, you may identify some improvements in your system that are giving you a lot more headroom with the same level of performance utilization, which is going to be perfect for essentially balancing costs and performance in your system. Same like, for example, if your application is changing something, Intelligent Insights is also telling us, for example, if we have query plans that are regressing from in terms of efficiency from the previous ones and is recommending us some actions in order to correct these query plans, making sure that our database is running as its best in terms of the queries that is executing. And again, you will find in the documentation a number of recommendations on how to query how to tune your performance queries so that you will always be able to find the best trade-off between efficiency, performance, and costs in your system. So what we have seen here over the last couple of episodes is this process where you basically start from some existing systems or some brand new solutions that you are deploying, and you start basically figuring out what is the amount of resources that will be needed in your system once this gets deployed. This is overall the capacity planning process that you should start thinking about when you are deploying something into Azure SQL database.
Thanks, Silvano. This has been really useful. I mean, from the beginning, just explaining how capacity planning is really such a critical process through kind of showing us the different options that are available, DTU or vCore, all the way through kind of evaluating our scenarios and determining what to do given a given scenario and how to adapt when things change. Thanks for joining us on this episode. We hope you like this video. Please like this video, comment, and subscribe to our channel. We'll see you next time on Data Exposed.